All right. Well, I'm sure some of you guys are really happy to see this, and some maybe aren't. But before we get into the live commentary aspect part of the game, where you actually hear my reactions and everything while we're playing, I wanted to do a quick intro and say thank you for the support on the BO2 and BO3 stuff. I know BO3 can kind of get a little stale as the year goes on, and a lot of Call of Duties tend to do that, even though Black Ops 3 is a relatively good game in comparison to Ghost and Advanced Warfare. At least in my opinion, it is. I like it a bit more, despite the issues that we run into constantly, and I do hope they fix those problems soon, the frame rate being one of the big ones. But you guys still have hung out, you still enjoy it. For those that do watch the Pokemon stuff as well, I also appreciate that because I have a lot of fun playing that game. And I'll probably still post it as long as I do have fun. So expect that stuff. If you'd like to see any future games as well, any new stuff that maybe I haven't uploaded yet, I know I've had a lot of requests for Rainbow Six Siege, Battlefield 1, maybe Titanfall 2. I might do some of those videos coming up in the future. It really depends on what I just enjoy playing. I'm down to try the games, but there's just no guarantee that I will like them, you know? So that's kind of where I my channel goes. And I know a lot of you guys have also said, hey, make a second channel for games that are like really nowhere near Call of Duty. I don't really want to do that. In honesty, if I want to post videos, I want to post them on the channel that I've spent years building up. And if you enjoy what I create as just, you know, a YouTuber, then you might like it. If you only watch me for the game that I'm playing, all right, but just know that it's not going to be the only game. So that's just a quick little thing there. Ending the round out with the Peacekeeper, though, we're going to be delving into the original Peacekeeper here. Get the quick kill. Coming in with the kill cam, 4-0 in the first round, and let's go into the actual video now with the reactions and everything. Thank you guys again, and I hope you enjoy. Well, we're coming back due to popular demand to Black Ops 2. So thank you guys for the love. I'm glad you did enjoy the last one. I hope you enjoy this one as well. And we're using the original Peacekeeper because they brought this gun back. Wow, thanks for the help, team. Holy shit, nice play, dude. They brought this gun back. What a horrible grenade. I suck. To Black Ops 3. And I really didn't understand the reasoning behind it, frankly. And it's mainly because UAV awaiting order. This gun is mediocre, but it's not unbelievable, you know? Not unbelievable. It wasn't like overly powered and broken when they first made the gun. But it does work really well in Black Ops 3. The guy in their team, I think that could have gone better. The gun wasn't overly powerful in this game because MSMC and PDW were really, really strong. And when you take the gun into Black Ops 3, it does compete much better with the weapons that are in that game. I don't know if it's because the gun balancing maybe is better overall or just because possibly they're just a little bit weaker in the SMG category, but overall, it works much better in BO3 than it does in BO2, because this gun, even though you saw me do decent work right there with it, it is relatively weak for the SMG class, so you kind of do rely on a lot of, not only your own skill, but a lot of luck as well. Let's run up, we gotta get out of the water here, it's gonna blow up on us. There we go. Oh, teammate, get him. Oh my god. No, he didn't have him yet. It's the fight of the battle of the jumpers. I'll get him for you. That was a quick game. Let's go into the next one because we might as well. Right now, I'm running Dexterity, Dead Silence, Grenade, Concussion, Toughness, Flak Jacket, Quick Draw, Extended Mags. Because Grip doesn't really do a whole lot in this game, so it's Grip is more effective in BO3, which might be beneficial to this gun or detrimental, I'm not sure. It depends on your outlook. But because Grip is bad in this one, I'm not going to use it. It's not very useful. Let's go to the next game, though. One more quickly. We'll knock it out. All right, well, we're on Nuketown again. The second Nuketown, not the third. Not the first, either. Don't get confused. The first is the best, the second is the second best, and third is... I'm not sure where to call a third. I don't even know if it's really Nuketown at this point. Which, honestly, isn't too big of a deal. It's not a big deal, I think, to have a weird Nuketown. There we go. Knock both of them out. Let's... Ooh, don't shoot me, please. Oh, please don't shoot me. Grenade! Alright, well, somehow we're still alive. Why'd he throw that? Let's run him away. Get the plant down. Really quickly, get the bomb down while we can. Play the objective. You guys know how the game's played, right? Alright. Reload it up. He's going for a trick shot. Okay. Oh, he's scared of me now. I'm wallbagging him. He's scared of me. I pushed him back. This game actually really depends. I wanted to mention this. This game's weapon balancing probably is not very good in comparison to BO3's. And despite me enjoying this game more, the M8 is by far like unbelievable. So is the FAL, like in the unbelievable category. They're that good. So when you have guns that are in the unbelievable category, it makes it very hard. Well, teammate, I gotta mention, standing in my way like that, probably not a good decision. I tried to do my business there. I apparently stunned the wrong person. My dude stepped right in front of me. Alright, we got hardside Nuketown first, because there's no alternate round switches. We're gonna have to just be used to it here and try to get lucky. Alright, there we go. Grenade off the wall there. Pick that guy up. Let's sit in the corner and reload. We need more ammo. There we go. Oh, pass. Run away from that. Run in circles. Oh, that's motion. And didn't work out. Wow, I'm getting drop shotted. Holy shit. And he got destroyed. Holy shit. Wow, okay. A lot of snipers right now, too, on the team. A lot of snipers. At least he got the kill. Not too big of a trade-off if I die there. Trading's never a bad thing, in my mind. Well, almost never. If as long as it's done correctly. If you're near me, I die, you get the kill. You know, something simple like that. It's not bad. Alright, now we got easy side. Well, easier side, I should say. It's better with a rifle, but I'm gonna be doing this anyway with this gun, so let's just hope it works out. Up over the top. Well, that worked out somehow for me. That's a person. Murdered the person, though. Let's push up, see if we can. Might die in the corner here. Nope, looks like we got lucky. Cool. Inmate in the far back, I gotta chill for a second. I can play and do get some damage on him, but I can't play too aggressive, otherwise I'll get picked off. Oh my god. Wow, I got redded. I got red-blooded really quick. I was like full screen red in a millisecond. Look at this. Alright, back to full health. I'm like, alright, I can push him. Look at this, I almost die. Shoot. Oh, there's only one bullet that hit me, but it turned my whole screen red with one bullet. Damn. Destroy. Okay. Defend the objective. I feel like I've missed a few points this game that I wanted to talk about, peacekeeper-wise. Oh, the weapon balancing, yeah. So the weapon balancing this game is, it's not gonna work, I forgot about the grenade timer. Is a little bit worse. Jump back out, nice play. Smart play. I can predict it, but it was a smart play regardless. Hello. What the fuck is that guy doing? UAV, you got it. Where's he at? He's way over there. Holy crap. But because of how the Peacekeeper works in Black Ops 3, it's a much better weapon in terms of how it's balanced out. Because there's no MSMC, really. I mean, you have, I guess, the Vesper and you have the VMP. But there's no MSMC where it's the strongest gun and also has the lowest amount of recoil. The Vesper, by all means, is actually the fastest kill time, like, in the game. It kills you so quickly. But because of the recoil in the gun and how fast it kicks up, you can't really use it at medium and long distances, where the VMP can be used in medium and close range distances, high rate of fire, but doesn't kill as quick. So the Peacekeeper has an opening where you can get in the long range and the mid-long range, and you can use it with rapid fire, because rapid fire in this game lowers the actual damage of the weapon as well. It doesn't do that in Black Ops 3, and it makes it a more usable weapon overall. And that's why the weapon balancing works a bit better in Black Ops 3 toward the Peacekeeper than it does in this game, and why people didn't use the Peacekeeper much in this. Either way, it's still kind of a weird thing on why they brought it back, because typically they bring back weapons that were very popular in the first game, and the Peacekeeper just didn't fulfill that role of a popular weapon. Although it does work a lot better, like I said, in BO3. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you for all the love. Hope you still like Black Ops 2 as well. We might do some more of it, maybe some MW3, MW2 coming up on the following weeks as Black Ops 3 kind of gets a bit more boring for everyone because we've played it for way too long. And yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.